Hi guys, welcome back. In today's episode, I'm going to show you how to download, install, and configure Intellij IDEA for your potential programming. Before we start, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel and like my videos as well. All right, so let's start. So this is the interface. So before we proceed, you have to turn into your google.com. And in your search place, you type in jetbrains.com and simply hit enter. So we are in the platform where we are going to download our Intellij IDEA. Okay, so under the developer tools, you simply click on that and the app we're looking for is this. I think you can also do this as well. They both are of the same IDE, but for today we're going to do Intellij IDEA. So let's simply click on this and you click on download over here. Next is this community for JM and Android development. So this is where we're going to click on and our download will start immediately. So this is just going to take a while, but I do not have to wait for that to be done. I already have my downloaded app, but if yours or when yours is successfully downloaded, you just simply go to this arrow key here, click on it and open in show in folder. So this is going to directly take you to the folder where this is downloaded. Okay, so I'm just simply going to post this here and I'm going to open my downloaded folder where I have it already downloaded. So this is mine here. So let me take this out. Okay, so this is mine here. I'm just going to open this and start with my installation. Okay, so next is to run this. Do you want to allow this app to make changes to your device? Yes, I do. So here I'm just going to click on next. Leave this the way it is and click on next. So over here, you would like to create a desktop shortcut. So it will be easier for you to locate the Intellij shortcut on your desktop. So simply click on this and go to next. Okay, so over here you just click on install. Okay, so this is just going to take a while. If you can't wait, please just skip down to the next step. Alright, so that is complete. We're just going to click on this Run Intellij IDEA Community Edition and click on Finish. Alright, so this might probably pop up in your screen, but if it doesn't, I'm sure the IDE would come up. But if this does, please just leave it on Do Not Import Settings and simply click on your OK. Okay, so over here you can change your background and customize this default settings here. So we have under here on the left hand side to customize this our IntellijE IDEA. Just simply going to click on that. And the color theme has a dark background here. JetBrains calls the theme Dracula. So this is a Dracula here. Maybe programmer prefers this dark background. If you don't, just simply go to this color theme over here and choose the color of your choice. You can decide to click that to make this brighter. Same with this. Alright. And over here you can also decide to change the font IDE. So that is your choice. I do not have to do that. Alright, so that's all for the installation. Okay, so next is to configure our IntellijE IDEA. On the left hand side, you see the plugins option. Okay, just simply click on this plugins. Over here, there are two tabs here, the installed tabs and the marketplace tab. So you click on marketplace, which is where we are right now. In marketplace, you type in the name of the software you want to install. So for today, we're going to install Python. Just going to type in the name correctly into that. Notice if you do not type the name correctly, the name of the software would not come up. All right, so please ensure to type in the name correctly. So next, we're just going to click on install to install the Python Community Edition, because this is the one that is most recommended. So you install this. Alright, so this is fully installed now. So the next thing we're going to do is to we have to set up so after this installation we have to go to our projects, okay, to create a virtual environment. Alright, so on the left hand side there's a project here. You just simply click on that. And the Python Community Edition is just going to install really well into this IDE. Alright, so that is done. So in order to create a virtual environment, okay, we're going to start by creating a new project. So first thing first is to click on the new project over here. So over here we have the name. Okay, these are the different steps to create a new project. Right, so over here you can decide to change this name over here, but I'm just going to do that. I'm just going to say first project. Okay, I'm just going to say first project. So what do we have here? Okay, you can decide to use any name of your choice. I've used that name before. So I'm just going to say FME. This location. Okay, so let's see. Okay, so this name has not been used before. Alright, so that is it here, and I'm simply going to leave this the way it is over here. And for the language, over here I do not have to create a repository. But the language is Python we are working on today. So I'm just going to click on that. Ensure that you have fully installed Python on your system before this process. Okay, so for the environment, we are creating a new environment and not an existing one. But the environment type is virtual and not any of this. So the location of this is going to be on the version of this Python we just downloaded. Okay, so this is actually the latest that I downloaded here. I'm sure probably if you're just downloading this, it's going to be the latest and it's going to show over here. In order for you to know that, just simply click on this drop down button and then you check for the latest, because that's where it's going to be. Or you might not really see it. The latest is just going to appear there. Okay, so for mine is 3.10. Okay, and this is what I'm going to do over here. I'm simply going to go over to this location and put on my slash and type in the name of the Python version that I'm making use of. So this is Python 3.10. All right. So if you're probably on the higher version, you can include that. Maybe the next is going to be 3.11, 3.12. So that depends. You just have to include it over here. Okay. So next thing is this base interpreter over here. So we have the inherit global site packages and make available to all packages. Okay, so the inherit lets you, the inherit here lets your virtual environment use packages in the main installation. That's almost what you need unless you want something specialized. For the make available to all projects, okay, it lets you use this virtual environment in all the projects you create. If you don't tick that box, you will need to create a new virtual environment for each project. All right, so all that being said, let us create a virtual environment. All right, so that is done. We're going to have some downloads down this area, and that is our SDK. Okay, so in Python, SDK means software development kit. Okay, it's the tools you need to write programs. Python SDK includes an interpreter that can help you understand your Python code and execute it. Okay, so the SDK also includes useful modules that you can include in your own code. For Python, those modules can be found in Python standard library. All right, so you should try to exercise patience for that to be properly downloaded. So mine over here, the SDK over here. So we're just going to let this properly download. So that's pretty much everything. So the SDKs are all installed. Now I'm going to show you how to create a new file under this project. So simply right click on this project name. And over here we have the new, and down to your Python file, just click on it and type in the name of the file. So I could just say my first project and hit, click on this, hit enter. All right, so this is the virtual environment for your programming. Okay, so have fun programming whatever you want to do. Platform is created for you already. Okay, so this is the end of the download, installation, and configuration of IntellIJ IDEA. I hope this was properly understood. If you have questions, please do not forget to make that on the comment section. And please do not forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. I'll see you next time. Bye.